Nitya Naresh, and I'm starring in the new film OGF. Actually, na acting career oka chance destiny. Aim plan cheyaledu, nen ankoledu ila nen actor avutanu. When I was growing up, I never ever imagined to be an actress, to be honest. I think childhood low, I wanted to be an architect. Dan tarvata, I wanted to be a fashion designer. After that, I wanted to be a travel log host. Only then, filmmaking came into my life when I reached my post-graduation. And then also, I thought I'll become an assistant director. And I actually settled in Bombay and I was applying for jobs with Dharma Productions and all that. I thought next 10, 15 years, I'll, you know, be like that. But sheer luck, destiny, fate, acting came into my life. And from all the industries, ee Telugu industry nunchi naku the opportunity came. To be honest, my first debut film was with my wonderful director Saikiran Adivi sir with Kerintha. And our film when I did it, it was a pure ilaga experiment laga to see if I'm good at acting. I always did theater, but film acting is different from theater acting. So I said, okay, let's give it a shot. I have nothing to lose. This film chesi malli, I'll go back to Bombay and continue looking for AD job and all. And I was an assistant director for advertising at the time. So I did this film with Sai Kiran sir. And to be honest, our cinema lo oka only 10-15 minutes role. It's a very small role, but for some reason I got recognized. Whether it was the curly hair, the dimple, the big eyes. For some reason, everyone liked my face. And they called me back and they were like, Nitya, you have to come, you have to join the industry, you should do more films. And to be honest, it was that time, Nandini Nursing Home time, which was my first lead role in the industry, that I actually realized that, okay, naku ee career chala ishtamaindi and I want to do this, and touch wood, I'm fairly good at it. So that's when I decided that I'll make a career out of acting, and I'm making the most of it for as long as I have, because I don't know how long I have here. I'll become an actress. Even in my mind, in a space, I didn't think about it. So my father is from the Navy. In a 4G background, we grew up. It's a government life. And when you grow up very practically. You know, you have very practical dreams, realistic dreams, and you always set goals that you can achieve. So I never really thought, because we don't have any filmy background, don't have any godfathers in the industry, I don't have any kind of association with the film industry up until this point. So I didn't think about it at all, but I feel like God has a hand on everything, and I think this was just meant to be. I actually fell in love with filmmaking in my college, in my degree. And so I did my post-graduation in filmmaking from St. Xavier's, Mumbai. And our time, I was staying in Mumbai, and one of my local guardians, her friend was an architect and his passion was photography. So our time low, when I used to keep going to their place to hang out, chill, and college time low alone, you keep saving money, so you're happy to eat a free meal from anybody's house. So our time low, I met this new person and he said, you know, my passion is photography, you're very pretty and all. Oka fun ki oka photo shoot chedam. So I said, yeah, what do I have to lose? So I did a photo shoot with him in Bombay just for fun. And my local guardian who was there, she had styled me and she had, you know, done my makeup and hair and given me all these pretty clothes to wear. And na life low, the first time I did a photo shoot. And I did it, and for fun, I put it up on Facebook, and that's when people started noticing me. And those were the pictures that some managers noticed and called me here to Hyderabad to do films. So yeah, that was the, I guess, brought the opportunity into my life while a photo shoot. Our debut film was Kerintha with Sai Kiran Adivi sir, and even though it was a short experience, it was a very wonderful experience. And I think so far all the directors I've had, I really connected with him. To my surprise, unlike other directors, he's very quiet and calm, and you know, it's very surprising to find a director like that. Kerintha time low, sir had told me towards the end of the shoot, Nitya, you're very talented and we'll definitely work again in the future. Any directors illa cheptaru, I never thought he'll actually come back to me. And then 3 years later, he calls me, 2017, he's like, Nitya, where are you? Come, let's meet. And we sit in Starbucks and he pitches me the script of OGF. And I was just, I think from my first first narration, I was in love with the story. I mean, I can't reveal much, but there's so many things I love about the story, which I'll let you guys know soon. And Saikiran sir, I find him a very creative person. I've heard many of his scripts, many of his stories, and one of his best things is he always has these twists that nobody expects in almost every one of his stories. Even the stories he's not made into films yet, but we know many of us have heard. So I think he's a very talented director, and I wish him all the best in a very great and successful future. Everyone asks me that because my dad's a 4G dad. So 4G dads, ela untunde, they are very protective, they are very, you know. But mana family lo chala, everyone's chala close, everyone talks about everything. Naku oka sister undi, so we, you know, we're a very close family. Mana family lo, whenever there's a life-changing decision, mana andaru kalsi oka sari, we'll sit, we'll discuss the decision, the life decision we want to make, and we always make it together. So when Kerintha happened, to be honest, nobody took it too seriously at that time. Manamandiram bus, we just did it for fun. After that, when my career got serious, I remember sitting down with my dad and I was like, okay, what's the plan? E career kavala vadda and all that stuff. And I sat down with my family, my mom, my dad, my sister, me, four of us sat. And we took a family vote. We took a family vote saying, is everyone okay with this? Because I feel like it's not just an individual decision, it's a family decision, because everyone is involved in it some way or the other. And everyone voted yes. And I told my parents that there's only one condition I'll be in this industry, is if you guys will be with me all the time. Because oka heroine ki oka support system, emotional support, physical support, I think it's very important to not just survive, but to do well in the industry. You really need that kind of backing from family, from people you care about, people like Nijanga Chapte, no one has your back the way your family has your back. So I had decided that as long as they're with me, I'm here. So I told my dad, anyone who's met my dad knows he's always with me. Sun low, rain low, bad weather, good weather, horrible conditions, best conditions, he's always by my side and shoot. And Nenu Chepanu, Dad, the day you're tired and you can't do this anymore, tell me, because I can't do it without you. But it's a big help to have my family with me. Nenu, to myself, actually, when I joined this industry, I made a promise. I love me the way I am, and I promised myself that I'll try my best not to change as much as possible. Because, you know, when you enter, like, e-industry is very different from the kind of life I've lived growing up. It was very simple, very basic. It is easy to get carried away. It is easy to, you know, shoot up like a rocket. But I promised myself I'll always have my feet on the ground and my eyes to the sky. So I think I've kept my promise to myself and I've not changed that much. But I love the industry. See, Nijanga Chapte, every industry key, two sides to a coin for everything. But I'm really lucky that I only have to deal with one side and my dad deals with the other. So I survive very happily. I just deal with all the good things. I do my creative part. I thoroughly enjoy my job. To have wonderful co-stars. And like I said, naku filmy background ledu anduku. All my filmy friends are people I've worked with, and then they've stayed my friends even after the projects. And they've introduced me to their friends, so they've become friends. So I have been very lucky to make some really good, sweet people who are also honest and down to earth and not fake and stuff like that. So in Kerintha, I made friends with Teju, Tejaswini Madiwada, and Sumanta Ashwin and Vishwant. And till this day, and Nuk Raju, of course, who is my co-star in this film also. And till this day, we're all friends. We all meet on birthdays and, you know, festivals and all that stuff. And then Naveen from Nandini Nursing Home, he's also being a really good friend of mine. Because of him, I met Saidharam Tej and Rashi and Regina, and we all kind of spend our important occasions together, and they're really, really sweet people, and I really enjoy spending my time with them. And now in this film, you know, it's not just my on-screen crew, but I feel like I have a lot of friends from my off-screen crew as well. A lot of my ADs and, you know, all the assistants, the technical crew, they all become like really good friends, and I'm a very people's person. Okay, cinema team is a unit. A unit has to work together to do anything well. I feel like OGF's team has been one of the most sweetest, loveliest people that I know. all, you know, Keshavanna, Chantiana, Mahiana, Maliana, so many people on my team who are so sweet, so welcoming, so warm, that you feel like coming to work the next day, and it's not like, oh, work, but you actually want to come to work, you know. The backstage crew is just as important as your on-screen crew. On-screen crew ki kuda chemistry kavali, backstage, you know, back of the camera crew ki kuda chemistry kavali, understanding undali. Your director and you have to have a chemistry, so he knows exactly how to get the best work out of you. I've been lucky to work with directors like that, Saikiran sir included, and your DOPs. I mean, the best chemistry has to be with the camera, of course. Sasha, Etel Foji girl. We've all seen her for like more than a year on TV, hoarding everywhere. She's puckered our brains totally. So when Sai sir called me saying, Nitya, he calls me one day, he's like, I finalized the other girl. I'm like, okay, who's it, sir? He's like, you know, Etel girl. I'm like, yeah. Like, yeah, yeah, that girl. I'm like, sir, but she has boy cut, sir. So then he's like, no, it's grown out now. She's very pretty. I'm like, okay. So everyone's like, okay, this Bombay girl is coming and all that stuff. So I'm not a Bombay girl particularly, but I've lived there for a very long time. Like, I've lived there for 10 years. So I was like, chalo, I'll speak somebody I can speak nice Hindi with and have fun. And when I first met her, we met her for the first look shoot, she wasn't talking much. And I was like, oh no, she's not talking. Okay, I think it's going to be one of those boring shoots where only I'll be talking and she'll be listening. And after the first schedule, oh my God, that girl doesn't stop talking. I thought Nook was the most talkative, but Sasha beat everybody to it, okay? And she is just so sweet. She's a small ball of love, you know? I mean, I can't describe her any other way. She's the cutest, sweetest thing, and I've really enjoyed, because I have had to share a vanity with her for 3 months. And I have loved it. I have loved every minute of it. You never get bored, and she's so chilled out, and she's so adjusting. And I think I really made a, you know, like a sister from another mister kind of situation. And I'm for sure, if I ever go back to Bombay, I'm going to stay with her, and we're going to have like a really good time. Off screen and on screen, we kind of stayed really good friends in the movie. So I've really enjoyed that, since we had a lot of bonding. Off the camera, it was very easy to play, you know, roomies on camera. It was a very, you know, lovely and fun experience. Aim acting, ledu. Whatever we are chilled out in the vanity, it's exactly that only we're doing in front of the camera. I love arts and crafts. And anyone who follows my social media, my stories will always be filled with something to do with arts when I'm not shooting. So I'm not a great artist or anything. I can't paint like Picasso or anything like that, but I like making things. So I always learn new modes of art to make things. Like, I recently learned pottery, and I learned how to make things out of freehand clay. Then I learned stamp making, and you know, so I learned all these techniques because I love making things. I feel it's very therapeutic and peaceful, and whenever it's an occasion, no matter how much money I earn and big I grow, when I give someone something, I feel it more personal when I give them something I made or, you know, something I wrote. So I still do that. I spend a lot of my free time, you know, recycling. So I make vases out of like wine bottles and things like that. I love dancing. It's been a lifelong passion. Again, I'm not the best at it, but it just makes me feel good. It's good for the soul. I'm a bathroom singer. A few people only know that. I'll tell you in the future. So right now I have two of my films coming out. One is very proud to present OGF, directed by Saikiran Aadhi sir, which is hopefully releasing in the next month or two. And another film of mine that's releasing at the same time is my Malayalam film, Ennalam Sharad, directed by Padma Shri award-winning director Mr. Balachandra Menon. So I'm very excited for both these films. I have been lucky to work with directors who are very, very skilled and have given me the opportunity to play really good female characters, which I appreciate them both for. So yeah, so these are my next two projects, and the ones after that, I shall, you know, break ke baad, I will reveal. OGF, I remember asking Sai sir, what genre will OGF come under? Like, it's comedy, it's action, it's suspense, it's romance. Like, there's so many genres in our one film that you can't really put it under one bracket. So I feel like it's going to end up becoming a genre in itself. And if we achieve that, that's a very big accomplishment. So it is a multifaceted film. It's going to be jam-packed. You're not going to be bored for a second. whether it's a love story going on or it's action going on or it's something you're waiting to find out because there's a big question mark on your head, you know, there's always something happening and it's always entertaining. I feel like my entire crew and my cast have put in so much hard work and they've done such a good job making this film. I really want you guys to watch it in theatres and enjoy watching it as much as we have enjoyed making it, because we really have, all of us. Nijanga Chappalante, I've joined the industry very recently, so I started watching Telugu films very recently. So I love Mahesh Babu films and I love Nani's films because he came from, you know, nowhere, and you know, I love Nagarjuna sir's films and there's so many films that I love. But heroines lo, I have a favorite because Telugu cinema lo, the first film I ever watched in Telugu was Arundhati by Anushka. And I fell in love with her. I was just like, wow, like such a, at that time only there was such a powerful, you know, female lead and she acted so well. And after Bahubali and all that, I mean, she's just gotten 10 times better. So I was a big fan of Anushka from the beginning, even before I moved to Hyderabad, you know. So I would say Anushka. Can I say Sai Kiran Adivi? But no, like I said, I only started watching, so I also love Trivikram Garu's movies. I like Rajamouli sir's movies and I'm still exploring my, you know, directors and movies and languages. So I think I'm going to go with Arundhati because it was the first ever Telugu movie I watched and it'll always be very close to my heart. And personal favorite ante naku epic films chala ishtam, period films, you know, like of kings and queens and stuff like that. So my father ki two girls unai. He doesn't have any boys, so he raised us like boys. Whether it was running around the army obstacle course on my knees, bruised elbows, running up and down, playing all kinds of sports. So my sister and I have grown up watching a lot of action movies. So for some weird reason, action comedy has been one of my favorites. So like, for example, all the Marvel films, I'm like the first one sitting there, first day, first show. So like, I'm a total tomboy like that. My favorite, I was the biggest Harry Potter fan like around me, you know. So I was big time on fantasy and fiction and, you know, the supernatural. What I love about this industry also, film, books, this entire world that I have had the absolute privilege of being a part of, is I love the fact that you can be anyone, go anywhere, do anything. There's such a magic in it. And I guess I may not have wished to be an actor, but I used to always love disappearing into another world, you know, where the laws of physics of our world doesn't apply. So that way is I love my job. I'm allowed to be a different person every 6 months. I've actually started listening to a lot of Tamil music recently. I don't understand much of the words, the lyrics, but I feel like music has no language and that is the best part about it. And I've really started to like Anirudh's music. He's a music composer and I started really love his song. Please watch our film in theatres this August. Do not support piracy and come support us. Show us all your love and watch the movie in theatres near you. Bye.